Tonight on Planet Time, we'll be discussing water on the planet Earth. The local inhabitants are almost entirely made of water. They drink it, they wash with it, and they even play in it. Water is life. On Earth, water continually moves around the planet. In the heat of the sun, water particles evaporate, rising into the atmosphere until they start to cool. They condense, form clouds, and fall back to Earth as rain. The water runs down the hills, forms rivers and lakes, travels underground towards the sea, giving life to plants and animals alike. The water creates and maintains vital ecosystems in balance and harmony. People can work and live in sympathy with the entire water cycle. A veritable utopia. Man, animal, tiny bees flitting across a summer sun-dappled lake. Ah. But this is only half of the picture. For many Earthlings are greedy, and their meddling is even causing the Earth's climate to change. They think that the water is theirs to use as they please. But the water cycle is fragile, and disruption of any part of it affects the whole. Many Earthlings force water to meet their demands. They don't realize their reckless use of water comes at a great cost. Where they choose to build, live, and work may bear no relationship to how much water is actually available for them to use. They have strange laws and practices that drive them to squeeze more out of the earth and cram too many animals onto the land. And at the same time, they blame their planners and farmers, even though they are just providing what people demand. Earthlings drain their planet's wetlands and destroy its ability to absorb the dirty water that pours off fields, roads, and out of houses and old sewage works. They have even made their rivers run in straight lines to take away the wastewater as quickly as possible. But water cannot be controlled entirely. It will always find its own way. Water is life. When will Earthlings realize that looking after water is everybody's business? Next week on Planet Time, we look at the progress made on Zargos 5, where groups of farmers, planners, and environmentalists worked together to solve remarkably similar water problems. Good night.